or in English, $250,000 in bonuses, added to the $100,000 that comes to the race winner, a potential $350,000 payday. Right now, Danny Sullivan, the moment of truth as they bring him off the corner.
That's right, he's got to bring him off here smooth, get a good run in there. Think how much trouble you had saying that. Think what he's thinking about winning that $250,000.
I'd rather not think about it. It's time to go racing. Herta, a bit of a sloppy start.
Very sloppy, but Dario Franchitti, they all slotted into place. He's gonna take a look. Brian Herta says no.
Christian Fittipaldi took a look at the inside. Oh, one of the players' cars bounds across the concrete. Christian Fittipaldi on the left, and Paul Tracy in the green and white cool car also nosed into this schmozzle. We have a yellow flag immediately. Max Pappas goes to the end of the chicane. There is Robbie Gordon. To the left, we saw the defending race champion, Mark Blundell. Oh, this is Michael Andretti is also in the middle of all of this. Let's
car
listen
runnable.
In.
Is all suspension on it?
I think so. I got a hit. I don't know how bad it is. I got to get a push start.
Was Lon Bromley from the kart safety team. There you see Greg Moore, second in points in the blue and white player's outfit, Christian Fittipaldi in the yellow helmet, and Paul Tracy walking off to the left. At least three cars, three top cars out in this first turn incident.
Okay, now you see in the back here, look at Greg Moore. He went sideways trying to get around a slower car. He's gathered it back up, but Christian Fittipaldi right there had to slow. They all come down and bunch up. Now watch Greg Moore in there. He goes across the grass, across a car. Bobby Rahal right in there. Michael Andretti there. And Christian Fittipaldi. Everybody has to take avoiding action. Got cars off in here, off in the sand trap. Look at that.
Six cars involved.
Somebody. Okay, here we are at real speed. Look up here. Greg Moore dove out there. Christian locks up. Greg goes right across the curb. I don't have any idea what he was doing there, but that was very much his fault. Poor Paul Tracy right there, comes in, has nowhere to go, runs right into the back of Greg Moore.
From Michael Andretti's onboard camera.
Okay, they're coming out of the last turn, down the straightaway. Accelerating up through the gears. Everybody's in line. Now they're coming down, everybody's easing over to the right. You see Bobby Rahal go to the right. Michael around the outside. Christian locks up over there, and all of a sudden he gets hit. Michael gets hit.
By Christian.
That was Christian Fittipaldi's back end that went into Michael Andretti.
On board with Bobby Rahal.
Christian right there, locks up. He's going through, Lynn. Look at Greg Moore just comes launching in over the curb, right into the back of the car. I don't have any idea what he was doing.
Greg Moore nearly took out his teammate, Patrick Carpentier, as he came flying down to that first turn, goes straight across the corner. We have a yellow flag. We'll take a break and return to Portland. Welcome back to Portland International Raceway. To the right of your screen, the festival occurs. We've been saying all weekend that they are the critical portions of this racetrack. Our first Toyota spotlight of the day is a no-brainer, the festival curves. Back in 1993, Nigel Mansell slid off in the festival curves. Emerson Fittipaldi came on to win. Michael Andretti and Jimmy Vassar knocked each other out back in 1994. In 1995, Andretti again with Brian Herta. Michael finished fourth, Herta was out. In 1997, on the exit of the curves in the wet, Alan Zer Jr. and Dario Franchitti both left the Budweiser G.I. Joe's 200. And moments ago, a new page in the legend of the festival curves. With six cars involved, Greg Moore is out of the race. That's our first Toyota spotlight of the day. Let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Greg Moore has made that walk back. What in the world happened? Do you have any idea?
It was just a huge bottleneck down there, and I'd made a really good start. I'd passed a couple guys in the start, and I went right down to the inside, and I got down there, and it was just amazing how slow it was down there. And just, kind of a mistake on my part, just misjudging how slow the start would be down in there. And, I feel bad for Christian. He was going to have a good race, and for Paul, but, my mistake.
How concerned were you going in that something like this might happen?
I was a little bit concerned about it, but, I had such a good start. And, it looked like it was nice and, it wasn't packed up. It looked like everyone was kind of apart from each other, and we went breaking into there. And next thing I knew, I didn't go in as hard as I've been going in all weekend, and it's just everyone had just completely stopped. So it was just one of those things that, I feel bad.
Greg, you say you feel bad for Christian and for Paul. Do you go talk to them about this scenario?
Yeah, I already talked to Paul and Christian on our walk back, and I told Christian, hey, I'm sorry I made a mistake, and Paul said, you okay? And I said, yeah. He says, well, good thing.
Thank you.
All right.
All right, thanks.